I put a roof on it. It's nothing fancy. It's just this. There's some sea lanterns. If you look at it from the top, I got some dirt in my old inventory there. Fire. You can see it's... Oh, server closed. Hello, everyone. I am Fanaqua. Welcome back to V4 Vanilla. Today, we're going to finish construction on our Enderbucks Coffee and Cocoa shop, coffee house, whatever we're going to call it today. Here it is. You can see I've added a little bit to it. I have actually finished it from the last time we were together. So I've got this little entryway. There's some doors. Inside is all not furnished, but it's constructed. The construction is all finished, is what I'm trying to get at. We'll get to that in a sec. If you look at the top, so the inside, the roof is nothing special. It's just slabs, whatever. If we go up here, we can see that it is also slabs. And I'm not sure how I feel about it over there. I didn't give too much thought to the roof, in all honesty. Maybe do something like this. And take these. Do a little of this action. Alright. It makes it look blend a little bit better, I think. Just like this. Not there. Whatever. We'll get to it. It's fine. It's fine. So yeah, that's the outsider. So what... Well, in... Words. I just lost all my words. I have a ton of stuff in my inventory. Basically, what we're going to do... So we're going to put seating in here, a little retail wall right here, and then this is going to be our espresso machine. And if you look back here, I've actually marked out all the spaces I'm going to need for the redstone. I say all, and then I go ahead and add some more. Whatever. I don't need you. I don't need your antiquated notions of, I don't know, something. Something or other. All right. I also have a screenshot of most of the redstone for this on my other screen, so I should be okay there. But what I want to do first is make sure I have all the materials that I'm going to need, or at least most. Quartz is going to be important. Wool can wait a second, but only a second. Only 1 second. Hope this works. There we go. Thank you. I only need two of these, so it's fine. And then I also need some sticks, but I'm going to need birch wood, so not with those. Just take a few sticks. Actually, a few more. And a little more. I think I need 16 or 18. I need, what, 4? So I need way more than that. Okay, I did not do the math right on that one. Let's go ahead and turn all of you into sticks, shall we? So basically what I need is... Actually, I'm going to need a lot more than that. Oh my goodness. You know, we'll start with 4. We'll start with 4, and I can come back and add some more later. Because basically what I want is... want to have a chair here, and a chair here, and these are going to be comfy chairs, so I want to have like little armrests on them. And then over here, I want to turn this birch wood into some fences, and I guess we'll maybe use one of these. One of those is as sticks, because we're going to need them. We're going to need a little bit more. Oh, I'm full up. Don't need those anymore. That's fine. Going to need a little bit more stuff for the, little more fences. Because basically what we're going to do... I saw enough fences. Oh my god. Alright, it's fine. Whatever. Hopefully this will be enough. Is have it come like this. And we're going to have little tables. Just, you know, little nice little things. Table. And I can't remember if I wanted 2 wide or 1, so we're just going to start like that. And then there, and then maybe a little 1 over there. And then over here, go ahead and add, actually that's a bit far. I think like that should be good. That should be plenty. I'm going to change this into string eventually, but that's fine for now. Okay. I do also need these to be... Ooh, I'm not going to have enough birch for this. Gonna need to get some more. That's okay. We can do it. Maybe I didn't want those to be birch. Oh well. We do now. Yeah, because that does not go well together. So maybe let's take these out. Let's make those like oak. That's fine. And that can be birch still. That's okay. I think that works. Oh, I had some birch fences up here already. Oh no! That makes me sad. I've wasted it. You want dark oak? Let's do that dark oak, shall we? And we'll use spruce to make sticks. We need a ton of those, apparently. Right. Alright. Is that gonna be enough? I think it will. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, and then we need our wool. Let's go and put that away. Got our black wool. Let's grab the white wool. Like this. Okay, and the black wool is going to be for the tables. Boop, boop. Boop, boop. Boop, and we'll put chairs in there too when we get the time. And the white wool is for the countertop. And that's why we have the redstone there, which will eventually be string. If we don't have it there, obviously, the carpet falls off and is sad. So there we go. White wool. Bam. Right, and so now what I want to do is actually put some iron back here. Maybe this is not right. It should be one further, shouldn't it? All right. Try that again. But this should be back here. 2, 3, 4. I think it goes one more in each way. Because you can kind of like do one of these, and then it's going to go there, and there, and I'm going to need two more in the middle. Get our redstone out. Look at this. This is coming together. So I've obviously built this already, because I know what I'm doing. I'm not like fussing and moaning. I still don't really like that, but we'll let it be for now. We'll see how it goes. I think the oak would look better there. It's not as much of a change. It would match the walls. Yeah, so I should have some iron. If not here, not here. Okay. Then I should have some in my ender chest. And Eilad's fancy shop is going to serve as my ender chest. There we go. Ton of iron. No problem. I planned ahead. Whatever. I plan ahead when I want to. Sometimes. Not all the time, but sometimes. Yeah. And what was I going to do with this iron? I was going to make some iron bars. Some iron fence. Boop, boop. Alright, so that's that. And then we take these guys and go boop, boop, boop. I'm thinking maybe would it look better like that? Not really. Yeah, I kind of like that better. Alright, so what I'm going to put in here are things like cocoa beans, a little clay cup, like a mug. Basically stuff you might expect to see in a coffee shop that they're selling. I did not bring any clay bricks or pots with me. I do have glass. That's one of the things. A little glass tumbler. I want to make it. And I should have enough for an anvil, right? 3. Yes, I do. So I want to go ahead and name these. I see you. I see you there, sneaky guy. All right. You can also see that I've extended the path a little bit here. Started doing this on a stream and then got distracted. That was actually when I ended up playing chess with Tricky. And then we did some decorating around spawn. I kind of hinted that it could go out this way because I think there was a plan for it to come out here. With these torches kind of thing. And if we go over here, it goes to like this other path here. I think that goes to like Dunmar's base. And then that kind of goes up to, like, the Holiday Town. So that's pretty neat. There's, like, a little hole in the in the tree there. There's this thing that I have no idea. Just 'cause, I guess. All right, yeah, so I have my anvil. I have my glass cup. Do I have any clay in here? Nope. I have tons of clay at my base, but I don't really want to go all the way back out there just for the cup. And I don't have cocoa beans. I'm not sure who's got cocoa beans. Oh, right, I want to make that have a name. So let's do that. Let's do that in here. Whoa, that was loud. One. Cold cup tumbler. Tumbler? Tumbler. Oops, this is gonna hurt. Woo! Alright, cold cup tumbler. Ta-da! And then I'm gonna have like some coffee beans, aka cocoa beans. I'm gonna have a cup, like I said, and I had plans for something else. I think I was gonna do maybe two of the cocoa beans. That would make sense, right? Anyway, so that's that done. Still need some more chairs for there. That's okay. This is a problem with having pressure plates. Zombies get right in. This one wants to come too. He's excited. It also helps that I'm on the edge of Spawn Town. So, like, you saw when I ran over here. Like, that's the game's death there. There's a portal over there. Some is right across the hill. You know, right over there. So yeah, it's not really lit up back there, so things are coming to get me. They track me from a ways. Okay, but yeah, let's move on to the redstone portion of this project. So the whole, ooh, hi. God damn, get out of here. So the whole idea here is that this is going to be an espresso machine that shoots out. You're gonna hit a button. You're gonna hit a button that I totally have in my inventory already. And it's going to activate and then shoot out an espresso at you, a coffee. So basically what we're going to do is start out. All right, and the cool thing about this is not just that it shoots out, it's that you can see it brewing right in front of your eyes. And it's done with this lava dispenser. So if I put a block in here, I'll need that eventually. It doesn't actually work like that yet. But basically, it's gonna when you hit the button, it's gonna activate the lava, and the lava is gonna be on, and then it's gonna turn off, and then this is gonna shoot out. So it's like the lava is in there, like as the coffee pouring through, brewing right in front of your eyes. I don't know. I just think it's really neat. And yeah, so we're gonna need this here. These are like the actual hoppers, actually. Let me go ahead and name one of these, because I found out you could do that. I did not know you could do this. So watch this. So if I have my anvil here, all my levels, I can say bean hopper. It's gonna be named bean hopper. I'll go ahead and name this one bean hopper too. Although it's not actually gonna be used. Hopper. Now they stack. And now if they come back here, I put them like this, and like this. If I look in the inventory, it says bean hopper. Look at that, so cool. This just says dropper. This would just say dropper, but it says bean hopper because I renamed it, and then it stays. That's really neat. Nothing else in Minecraft when you name it. Like if I were to, what can I place? I can place this guy, right? If I name this guy, tablecraft. So you can see it's named tablecraft in my inventory, but when I place it, not named anything. Still not named anything. And if I use my axe and pick it up, or anything really, it's not named Tablecraft anymore. So, oh well. Anyway, so this is the front of it. I think that button's okay there. I'm gonna have to double check that though. So then what we need is my hoppers, my proper hoppers. They're gonna go into here. They're basically, this is gonna be the thing I put all of my beans into, or all of my potions into, and they're gonna go into here via these hoppers. Oh, this is not right. This needs to be up one more. All right, so yeah, that's gonna be there. And then I need to put redstone on top of here and here. And what, one more, two more? There we go. I'm just going to start with my redstone. No, I'm not. I'll just do the process. So here we go. I'm going to put one more there. Nope, not yet. That's going to go this way, this way. This is a secondary circuit, so it's going to be a secondary pulse. So I'm going to do that. And these are all four ticks. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So basically when I hit the button, and actually I need that block to not be there, which is fine. Okay, cool. Yeah, I'll just take that out and replace it with this guy. Bam. All right, cool. So yeah, when I hit that button, basically what's going to happen is the red, this will activate. This block will activate. It'll send a pulse up here into... Actually, it needs to go up higher. Into there. And that's going to activate the lava. And then, in the meantime, this the pulse is going to be delayed along these repeaters until it goes up again and activates that dispenser. So basically, the lava will go. And I think I should be able to show you this now. See? Look at that. That's so cool. So that's the brewing coffee right there. That's the part of this that I love. Now, if we finish it off, we also need a pulse over here. Not a pulse, but a redstone line. Not sure how long it needs to go. Start with these. I need 1, 2, and then these again. 1, 2, 3. This goes here, and what is this doing? This is controlling. This is the part that I can't see on my map, or on my screenshot. But basically, it's activating the. It's gonna shoot out the. Oh my gosh, my words are not with me today. It's gonna shoot out the actual potion. I think. I definitely have a system in place for this. Because right now it's going to go oh no, it won't go twice. It won't go twice. Right. We're good. So if I put something in here, let's put several somethings in here and activate this. It does not activate because it's not a strong enough pulse. What if I do like this instead? Boop, boop. And then that needs to be a thingamajig and a thingamajig. Alright, so now if I have all the things in there and I press the button, let's add some delay into that. So that way it's after. Okay, how about that? Cough? What? Oh, it just did it there. Why did it do it there? Do I need this? I'm confused. It's not often I confuse my... Actually, that's a lie. I confuse myself quite a bit. Why does it do that? Oh! I already have a thing in place for that. What is this thing, then? Now I'm really confused. So wait, if it works without that... Why do I have that there if this makes more sense? That's for the lava. Wait, what's activating this thing? Oh, this block. This block is activating it. Because it's powering that. Is it bud power? Is that what's happening here? What if instead of this... I know. I'm trying to think of a weaker way to power this thing. I guess by moving this back one. So put that there, and then do like that. And that should, in theory, work. Maybe, by being a weaker power source. Right, okay, so that's working. And then we just need to add this thing in to actually... bring the bring the potion out to play, so to speak. Bam. Okay. So now if I hit the button. Nope. It's too fast. It needs to be slower. Boop, boop. Boop, boop. Wait, I'm confused. Now I'm really confused. If I hit the button, is this being powered by this? What is powering this thing? God damn it. This should not be powered by anything right now. It must be a bud power situation, but this didn't happen to me before. What the heck? Alright. So that's... Obviously, it's that this is being... No, it shouldn't be being powered anymore. And, like, when I break this... It still works. So it's not this thing at all. What about if I take this out? Is that being powered somehow? Probably. Nope. Okay, it's not that. It's still this thing. I thought I fixed the problem, but I didn't. So, what exactly is happening here? So this is powered, and it's bud powering this. But this is a weak power source, so it shouldn't pass it along. So it shouldn't be that. Puzzling. Very puzzling. This worked without fail, I must say. On my test world. Maybe I have some blocks where they shouldn't be. The only thing I can think. Because that powers this, and then that comes around and powers that. Oh wait, I should have another thing here, right? I have this guy there. That must be where my button is on the other one. I mean, if that's the case, then I should be able to put you there, you there, you there. But I don't have that there like that. Very interesting. What if I take you out? Take you out. Put you back in. And then hit the button. Over there. In that spot. What do we think of that? Fingers crossed, guys. Fingers crossed. Well, it's not going to work anyway. Because this is not connected. That would help, right? So, right, that goes there. And then... Power. Just trying to see, like, is it... powering somewhere else, too? I don't know. Bam. Okay, so it's not activating anymore. Okay, it's not activating that anymore. I don't know why, but it's not. I just can't. Just can't. I don't know. Okay, so I got three. Go ahead and put that one there. Boom, boom, boom. Now what? What if I replace that too? Oh, those are already on four ticks. Like, it's not even there yet, though. I don't know, because it's like whenever I... It's only when I place this. When I take these out, I can take all these things out. And then hit the button again. And it... What now? Is this... Am I just stupid? What is going on? Like, it's not even... Is it that big a deal? See, now it's not doing it. Why is it not doing it now? I changed literally nothing. I honestly don't understand. What? I'm gonna go to my creative world, I'm gonna look at this, and I'm gonna come back, because I've been rambling on about what for too long. Alright guys, I figured it out. Went on to my building world, and I messed around, and I figured out that the block that is after, well, I'll just show you, because you know me in words, especially today, it's not working out. I'm sick and tired of this damn espresso machine not doing what it needs to do. So we can go ahead and put these back in, because we do need these here. But not there. Or there, necessarily. No, we want them right there. Not there. So yeah, this can all be redstone. Bam, bam, bam. So the issue I'm having here is that this block is not just a block. This is actually here as part of a monostable circuit. So different kind of block we need. Go ahead and put that there. So this should now make it work perfectly. It's gonna shorten the pulse and should just do what we need it to do now. So ready, set, go. Okay, that was two. We don't want two. Why did we get two? Boop, 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 boop. Shouldn't have activated twice. Why did it? Why indeed? Try again. Maybe that was a fluke. Nope. Okay, let's try again, and this time look at it. Seriously, why did it activate twice? Boop. This must be activating it still. Still slash again. So let's go ahead and do the old trick we just did. We put this down, and then a bit of redstone. Hopefully that fixes this problem. I figure it's got to be just because it's on a server. There we go, just one. Cool. So every time you hit the button, you're going to get out a dispensed item, and usually, hopefully, it lands on the counter. If we go down here, get all of my potions. Just go ahead and put a couple of these things away. And then I'll go ahead and load these up into the bean hopper. Actually, wait, no, I wanna name these. So what would we call our drink? It would obviously be something very catchy and ender related. And at the same time, have to do with coffee. Maybe an espresso. Espresso. So I'll go ahead and do that, and then we'll join you for the inaugural dispensing. Alright, guys, welcome back. So we have all of our espresso loaded into the bean hopper. The way this works, I actually need to prime it once, so... Oh, I guess I don't. I guess it'll just come right out. That's cool. So let's put that back in there, then. And there it is. All right, cool. It flies right in your face. You just come up to the counter, order what you want. Bam! Out it comes. And that's actually cool, because potentially... I could load a different kind of beverage. I could, you know, I could move this down to activate from that block, and then I could put another hoppers over here, so I could have something in here. I could load this up with something else. This could be my espresso, and this could be, I don't know, something else. I think that's gonna be plenty of storage. I don't think it's gonna be too popular. mostly I just like clicking the button and watching it brew and then dispense, although it dispense a little bit quickly still. Let's maybe just do like that. How do I feel about this? That's actually pretty much perfect. Yeah, I like that. That's cool. If I do say so myself. Yeah, I don't remember why I needed that there. I think it's because the pulse, this shortens the pulse enough so when it activates the first time, it doesn't activate the thing. That would be my guess. I just saw that that was there in my test world and came right over. I didn't even bother looking at it. I don't even want to know why, to be honest with you. I'm just happy that it works. So let's go ahead and put that wall back in. I was thinking maybe doing like some kind of maintenance hatch, but we don't need that there. But you know, I don't think we need it. I think it's gonna work fine every time. So yeah, there we have it. This is, I do need to put some cakes in, and I need a couple more chairs here, but other, and you know, some more retail product, but other than that, we are pretty much done. I'm gonna put a sign in here. Can I make that sign now? I should be able to. The one thing about this, you have to be going quickly through these doors. If you just try and walk through the doors, actually it works there, but like if you stop, okay, well sometimes it doesn't work unless you sprint or hit both of them. You gotta hit both of them too, or go right through one door like that. Yeah, so you're definitely gonna want those espressos to get through the door. Let's take some wood. Need a couple. I don't need slabs. Here we go. Oh, I had sticks for days. Oh well. So much for that spruce wood. Alright, so here we're gonna put a little sign. Espresso. One diamond. Diamond. Each. Where should they pay? Where should the people pay? Maybe we put a little chest here? That could be good, right? Or maybe, I'm thinking maybe like a hopper. Like, just so you literally just like throw it over the side. I kind of like that idea. Let's do that, yeah. Yeah. So we'll need a bit more wood. Sure, why not? We'll need two chests for this. One is actually not going to work. So let's just do this for now. Yeah, because I don't have enough iron on me. I've used a little bit too much. We'll just put a sign there. Pay here. Pay here. And we'll do a down arrow. And a V. Pay here. Okay, yeah, and this will be the espresso, one diamond, and if we want something else, we'll put it in there. But for now, I think this is pretty brilliant. And, you know, maybe we'll sell these two eventually at some point, but for now, I think it's fine. It's just like a display item, and maybe people can special order it if they want. The main goal here, main thrust of the thing is the coffee sales, the espresso. So thank you guys so much for watching. As usual, when I work on a redstone project on camera, I derp it up big time. So thanks for bearing with me. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this has inspired you somehow to do something similar with other stuff or something along those lines. But have a great, awesome day, guys, and I will catch you in the next episode. Bye.